about critical infrastructure of our country. Said right.
This is the massive refinery is located in Texas City. If you're driving a vehicle, more than likely, that fuel came from here. So, I think it's something to be spectacle and beheld.
Oh, man.
Chelsea disagrees, but I think it's quite fascinating.
Looks like Commerce City.
Oh, stop.
No, we shouldn't tell people about these cookies. It'll ruin their lives.
It's a secret.
I wish these were made with all kinds of health and goodness in them, but they're not. But they're so good, and we have to eat them while Naomi's in the other room.
They're really good. They're wafer cookies.
They're so delicious.
Show them, Nate. How are you supposed to eat these cookies?
Like this. These ones are so bad in it.
I'm so sorry, you guys. It's been a boring week.
Our week's been so boring. We'd like to say we had some cool, awesome things to show you.
It's been a snore fest.
But our week's been a total snore fest.
It's so boring. We're sitting ducks, and our most exciting thing every day is feeding the ducks.
Little House on the Prairie.
And watching Little House on the Prairie.
I picked oranges
yesterday.
Those are
the highlights. I mean,
I found an orange tree in some person's yard, and then I picked some.
But they weren't ripe.
They were all right. They were full of seeds. I ate all those seeds because those seeds are good for you. Needless to say, it's just been really kind of bumming.
Yeah.
Not in a bad way. Just boring. Just boring.
So...
I'm writing a lot, which is great. Oh.
There's cows. We're walking noodle.
She heard us eating our cookies.
I mean, I don't...
She's coming.
We are in the RV. And we just have the ducks, feed the ducks.
Feed the ducks?
Mm-hmm.
You know.
Week five.
Yeah.
High five. Oh!
Guess what?
We're not the best high fivers.
We're sitting ducks.
Yeah,
and it's not been the best. Chelsea's going to insert a lot of duck footage because that's been about the highlight of our time here. We've had a whole lot of duck action. And
they're little scrappers, man.
They know how to beg, and
yeah.
They've been getting fed like kings.
Yep.
I think they've had more organic breadcrumbs than ever in their life. Chelsea likes to be generous, and I like to be frugal.
Yeah.
It's a good combo. Needless to say, the ducks are winning.
They're amazing ducks. Naomi's having a great time.
The last week has been about the same as... So, sometimes you have weeks that are full of farts. Sometimes you have weeks that are full of joy. This week has not been bad. Let's just say this. Thank you to everybody that has been sending us encouragement and prayers.
Yes,
and
thank you.
Some people have gone out of their way to even send us some financial support through a PayPal.
Sweet.
Thank you so much for
thank
that
you.
To help towards the generator. And that was bad. So we did go to get our generator worked on, and we're looking at like thousands and thousands of dollars in deeds, which completely wipes out our budget that we had going towards solar. We were really wanting to put solar on the rig. There's this like illusion out there in RV life that if you just have solar, you're gonna boondock forever.
It's like the epitome, like you've arrived.
You have solar. Oh. So we've had that total like fixation in our heads too. We would love solar. Don't get me wrong. We would love solar, but that's not gonna happen. We're gonna love our generator.
That's right. We're gonna love that thing.
And we're gonna
use it.
And we're gonna use it. So that's what we're going to do, and we are still waiting for that to get totally fixed. They are replacing the central control boards and blah, blah, blah. And I will show all of you the pieces and parts of that because I'm definitely going to keep those for a while to pick them apart. But in the meantime, we've done a whole lot of hanging out around here, and you can tell Chelsea's been super loving that.
We hate being stuck. But we did rent a car.
We rented a car.
Hey, Chelsea, do you remember how to drive?
Barely. We'll see how this goes. I could have had a Camaro, but it didn't fit a car seat in the back. I wonder why, you know? I wonder why they don't make sports cars for
Moo Moo.
For families. Come on.
Yes. All right. Enjoy the rental.
Which was so weird to drive a car after driving Big Bess here.
Chelsea went from car to car. She doesn't really drive the RV too much.
Yeah, but I haven't driven it forever.
But she hasn't driven in a long time.
He's my chauffeur. He drives me around.
I'm a good chauffeur.
He does. He drives me. A chauffeur.
You heard me right. it's true. She's got a chauffeur clip. I guarantee it. We went to the mall.
Oh, gosh.
Oh, yeah. It was awful. It was absolutely a nightmare. So there's this whole crazy, insane, like, holiday spirit that possesses people right now as they all get ready to go worship all kinds of idolatry. It's crazy out there. We had no idea. Okay, we've been removed from, like, the normal big city life for so long, and now we are...
And we do a lot of shopping online, too.
We do a lot of shopping online.
So we don't go to stores very often.
Let alone the big city malls. But, hey, it's Sunday. We have a car. Let's go to the mall.
So we're a little stressed.
Not a little. I'm losing years of my life. Look at my face. That's how I feel.
He's graying as we speak.
Oh.
And
this is everything why we did RV life to avoid.
Yeah, we don't like crowds.
Let me have my lemonade, Dad.
And it's crazy here.
It's chaos.
Maybe we just haven't been to the mall in a while, but like the whole holiday scramble is crazy.
This is consumerism defined. Like literally, this is the face of consumerism.
And it's stressful. Awful. And it's expensive.
All right. Let mommy have some. It was overwhelming.
It was so crowded.
There was, I'm not even exaggerating. There was probably 25,000 people at this mall. Easily.
In a frenzy.
It was frenzied.
You could feel it in the air.
You could feel it. It was like blood in the water.
Smell it in the air.
The sharks were out. Needless to say, we bought some candy to alleviate the stress.
Oh my goodness. Dang
it. We survived.
We survived.
We survived. Not well. Not well, mind you.
We may have bought a whole bag of candy.
It's not full, but there's some in there.
There's plenty.
Oh. Just as guilty as
Oh, that was so stressful. Oh, that fresh cold air feels good actually now. Oh man. The mall.
And really, right now, the big mission that we've got our eyes on the prize.
Potty training.
By us, I mean she.
You are gonna help too. Yes, you are.
I'm gonna text
you to tango.
Oh, that's true.
I need your help.
So there's gonna be 3 days of pee and poop, and then we're gonna be potty trained.
Naomi already has.
She pooped in the potty.
Yeah.
Okay.
Oh my god.
What'd you do, Nay?
I can show you right here, cause I can't open the potty mouth. You can see right here.
What'd you do?
Poop.
Yay, Naomi! Yeah! You did it!
Let me just poop again.
It's so cute.
That was about our highlight of the week, was our daughter pooping in the toilet.
She's so cute.
We did not see that coming, and that's, like, for any parents out there, that's legitimately, like, a huge deal.
We just thought we'd try, and we put her on there, like, not thinking she'd really do much, and then she's like, I pooped! Mommy!
And she did.
I pooped!
And she did.
And man, that girl pooped.
It was a big poop. We are so proud of her.
So
we're super pumped on that. That's been really exciting.
And she's very motivated by candy. And going to the mall and getting all that candy has really motivated her. So that's going to be great.
So that's been our big wins this week. We've had poop in a toilet. We've had ducks. We've had a generator that's an unbelievably expensive fix. We've had a rental car that cost a fortune. And we have gone we've gotten laundry done. They were all cordial and polite.
But there wasn't enough dryers, so we had to kind of hang dry and improvise in the rig.
So our rig's been full of laundry and a little bit full of despair at times. There's been some weeping, mostly on my part.
Oh, you want to talk about it? Do you want to talk about it?
For those of you that don't know... A big part of our journey out here is also to continue with my own healing journey that I have been on for a couple of years now. If you're not aware of it, I have written a book which kind of chronicles a lot of that process over the last couple of years, and I grew up in a very different world than most people did. And because of that, it has left me with a very different perspective on life and on my own quest for healing. That being said, it's been really tough as of late. And most of that has to do with really coming to grips with not letting myself get some healing done for some things that have happened over the past few months that have been very, very challenging. And so I'm very, very good at compartmentalizing. And that has led to a lot of things getting left on the back burner that need to be addressed. And I am finally focused on doing that. And that's really, really good, but also really painful. And so your prayers in that front are always really encouraged and thankful. I know we're always thankful for those as well. But this kind of dream that Chelsea and I had, that we would be able to kind of just go to these beautiful locations and sit at the beach and be able to just take it easy and relax and get healing in these wonderful places while Chelsea and Naomi have this great time going down and playing in the sand and
going for hikes in state parks
and national parks. And like, we had this whole kind of idea in our heads about how we would be able to do this and how we'd be able to be traveling around and going to different conferences and all these things. And you know what? We've been firmly planted here and not been able to move. And all of our expectations about every area of our life are being systematically stripped away from us. And we trust the Father in that, and painfully so. And you begin to recognize how you've made idols out of your own expectations and how each and every one of us is susceptible to doing that in our lives. And Chelsea and I had made a huge idol of this time. Really, I know I did, and I had this grandiose idea about being able to just spend all this time being able to focus and concentrate on healing and getting greater and greater freedom in my life, and yet we're kind of stuck in this situation that we can't do anything about, and we have to learn how to abide. And really, that's led us to be, honestly, spending a lot more time reading my Bible, which is really, really good.
That's good.
It's been really challenging to winnow myself down to kind of just that. So I would like to say that there is a ton of change happening in our life right now, but this week's update is pretty minimal. We don't have a ton to update you on because we're kind of sitting ducks.
Something I want to talk about real quick.
Oh, man. The InstaPot. I bet that's coming out of her.
No. I have been using the InstaPot a lot, but I made cornbread for the first time in our little toaster oven, which was awesome. And it came out really good. I made some vegetarian chili in the InstaPot. It was awesome. But no, I'm not going to talk about the InstaPot. I want to talk about our family time. So because we've been stuck here and we've just kind of been, I don't know, kind of more into a routine than anything, because living on the road, you're not really in a routine. You're just kind of going by the flying by the seat of your pants. But here, since we've been kind of stationary, we've been kind of getting into a routine. You know, we sit down, we have dinner, like, the same time every night. We go to bed the same time every night. We wake up in the morning at the same time. Like, we've been kind of getting more into a routine, which is not like us, if you know us well. But anyway, we've been watching Little House on the Prairie, which that is so nostalgic for me because I grew up on Little House and I love it, have very fond memories of that show, but I haven't seen it in a long time. And we are going through season one right now. And it is amazing.
It's wonderful.
It's amazing. And the Ingalls are such sweet Christians and they are going through the fire a lot. And it has been really encouraging for us to watch that. Like, just, okay, if you haven't even seen Little House on the Prairie, go and watch the pilot episode because they go through more in the pilot episode than most people will go through in their lifetime. And it is just, it's intense, it's awesome, and they keep pressing on. They keep enduring and onward. And I'm just, it's very inspiring. So anyway, and I mean, our two-year-old will sit and watch it. Like, I'm shocked at that because I don't know how many two-year-olds will actually sit and watch a show for that long, let alone, like, Little House
on the Prairie. And she'll engage in it. They have some complex things that are going on in there, and she loves it. And she's asking questions about it, and it's a good one for us. We're missing our friends. We're missing our friends back home. We miss you guys. We definitely are. And we would love to be beaching it and having a great time, but we're stuck here for a little longer because the repairs are going to take a while. And great man. Gave me some incredible advice. His name is Alan Aguirre. If you've not checked out his stuff, he wrote a book called The Feast Unlocked. It's absolutely incredible. I can't recommend it enough. He gave me some advice because he has traveled around in the past with his family in an RV when he was very big in the music scene as well, in the kind of more punk scene, Christian scene. And he said to me, if your RV breaks down, it's because you're supposed to be there. And that little bit of advice has gone through my head over and over and over and over. And I needed to hear that because here we are. We can't really do a whole lot and we have to abide. And I know it's an opportunity for our faith to grow. It's an opportunity for us to figure out what it is that our purpose is during this time. And we need to take advantage of that too. So for those of you that would like to follow along with our other material, please head over to snatchedfromtheflames.com. You can see my book there, Snatched from the Flames. You can also go to Amazon to find that. And your love and prayers and support is always encouraged. Thank you so much for everyone that's donated to us also at our snatchfromtheflames@gmail.com, our PayPal. Thank you for doing that. We really appreciate that. And I really hope each of you will take some time to click on this video. Like, share, subscribe, because you never know what's going to happen. We are rolling with the Reynolds, even when we're sitting ducks. We're still rolling. Oh, yeah. Hey yo, 1, 2, 3. 2, 3. Get up, we got victory. Go weather, bro, and me.
You know it.
You know it won't prosper.
Hey
yo, 1, 2, 3.
2, 3.
Get up, we got victory.
This is it.
Go weather, bro, and me.
You know it.
You know it won't prosper.
Hey.
Naomi was watching Torah Town. Apparently she clicked on something else and it was a gal knitting and she fell down. And Naomi said, Daddy, I'm worried about her because she fell. This is what my daughter is. She is such an empath and I love her.
Oh, she is.
But she is a squirrel.
Oh my gosh.
She is a total squirrel.
That's awesome.